हेलो, वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो एज यू नो, लास्ट क्लास वी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वेव्स. ओके, सो इन दैट वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज अ वेव. वी डिफाइंड अ वेव एज अ डिस्टरबेंस इन अ मीडियम. कैन बी हार्मोनिकल, कैन बी नॉन हार्मोनिकल और अनहार्मोनिकल. And we classified the waves into different categories based on the presence of medium. Okay, then we classified the waves based on the type of vibration, whether vibration is perpendicular to the direction of wave or parallel to the direction of wave propagation. So we classified into transverse, longitudinal, like that. Okay, so these are the essential thing that we have done last time, and we pointed out that we have to talk in detail about plain harmonic wave. Okay, plain progressive harmonic wave. So this module is purely devoted for talking about plain progressive harmonic wave. Okay, so we will first see what are the different properties of plain progressive harmonic wave, and we will try to express a plain progressive harmonic wave mathematically. And we will understand certain concepts related to that. Okay, so first let us see what is a plain progressive wave, or what are its properties or special features of plain progressive harmonic waves. Okay, so firstly, there should be a wave which propagate or advances to a medium without appreciable loss of energy. Okay, it must advance continuously without losing appreciable energy. So when energy is not lost, its amplitude will be almost a constant, since energy is not lost. This is the first condition. And secondly, this should propagate continuously. Okay, continuous wave propagation, not a intermittent one or not a pulse, nothing like that. Continuous wave flow, something like what we make on a wave string. For example, when you do some physical experiments in laboratory, we use some strings and we attach some vibrator on one end of this string or thread, and we continuously vibrate the string. So we can have a continuous wave propagation along the string, something like that. Okay, where energy is not appreciably lost and we get a constant amplitude throughout the motion. Okay, so this is the first condition. And secondly, what should a particles of the medium must vibrate to and fro about their mean position. That means every particle of the medium, you can see here in the animation, particles are continuously, constantly vibrating up and down. This is a secondary condition, and that vibration should be purely, we can say, symbol harmonic. Okay, we know already that is what is a symbol harmonic motion. So every particle should exist or involve in symbol harmonic motion. Okay, and thirdly, you can see the driving force coupled to the medium oscillates symbol harmonically. That means you need some vibrator here at the origin of the wave. You need some vibrator. It is a source of vibration. So that source should produce continuous symbol harmonic vibration. For example, in case of a string vibration in laboratory, you use some vibrator or some tuning fork or some electrically excited vibrator that continuously vibrates symbol harmonically, and that vibration is transferred to the string or the wire, and wire carries the wave continuously. So something like that required here at the source. And always such waves, from the discussed mathematical point of view, such wave should be able to express in terms of some sine function or cosine function. Okay, some sine function or cosine function we can use, and we can represent those waves. That is another condition, because there are so many different other waves also. Okay, you may ask why this is so special. There are many other waves where we cannot use a sine function or a cosine function symbol. We may need some other type of complex function to represent them. So, but for a plain harmonic, a progressive wave, you can represent them using either a sine function or a cosine. Both are equally applicable. Okay, and another feature of such waves are the amplitude of such wave should remain constant throughout its motion. Amplitude should not decrease as the wave propagates. Okay, this is an ideal definition. Ideally, you can say a plane progressive waves amplitude should remain constant. It should not get attenuated or decreases as the wave propagates. But you know, in reality, amplitude of the wave goes on decreasing as the distance increases. So you can see in any case, for example, you transfer some wave through a water medium, some big pond or a lake, you make some ripples, you walk some ripple at one end, you can see the ripple hardly reaches the other end if the pond is so wide and vast, okay, because the amplitude get a decreases. And even in the case of sea waves also, there is considerable decreasing wave height, you can say, but that is not noticeable because we can't see the other end. That is why. Otherwise, there is a constant or continuous decrease in the amplitude. Okay, but ideally, progressive waves amplitude should be constant throughout its length of propagation. And another important concept that you already know, that waves have crest and trough. Okay, waves possess crest and trough. We have already discussed in the previous class. Crest is the point having highest amplitude, and trough is the point having lowest amplitude. And you can have distance. You can measure the distance between two adjacent crest, or you can measure the distance between two adjacent trough. That distance is known as wavelength, and that wavelength should be always same. It should not change as the wave propagates. And of course, frequency of the vibration should also remain same throughout its propagation. Ideally, when it propagates through a single medium. Okay, we cannot say like that when the wave propagates from one medium into another medium, many parameters may change. Its wavelength may change. Okay, its amplitude may get changed. That is there. Okay. Otherwise, as far as a single medium propagation is considered, wavelength will be constant for a plane progressive harmonic wave. Okay, so here is a plane progressive harmonic wave. We are represented. Its amplitude is constant. Let us see how we mathematically represent such a motion. In the way you can see, you must understand the coordinate system. Horizontal axis is taken as the x-axis, and vertical axis is taken as the y-axis. Okay, the vertical displacement we show as y. Okay, and in fact, vertical displacement at any point is shown as y of x. And if you want to include time, you have to write it as y of xt. Understand, y of xt is used here to show the displacement of the wave at a distance x from the origin at a time instant t. And you know, it's a variable, x and t are variable, and of course y is also a variable. So it's a space dependent, time dependent function. Okay, it depends on two variables primarily, x and t. Understand? And suppose you want to measure the distance at the origin, you can put x is equal to 0. So we can write the displacement y as y of 0 t. And any displacement that we produce at the origin continuously propagates. So something produced at the time t is equal to 0 here, and it will reach at some time after a finite time. Okay, that distance depends on the velocity of the wave. Velocity of the wave can be easily found. If a distance travel is x and time taken is t, velocity will be obviously x by t. Or if you want to write t, you can write x by v. Then you will get the time taken to travel the wave. Understand? So this is the y of 0 t is the displacement of the wave at the origin. Okay, at the time instant t. Okay, and suppose you want to write the displacement at a distance x at a later time instant t dash. Okay, something happened at the origin at t, is propagating along the x axis and reaches at a distance x. So that displacement, that particular displacement, but that happened at the origin, reaches somewhere at a distance x. So then that displacement at a distance x, we denote it with a point P. Okay, P at a P, you can represent as y of x t dash is equal to f of t dash minus t. Understand? Here, what is this f? This represents the wave function. Wave function is a mathematical representation. General mathematical representation is f of t dash minus t. For f can be anything, it can be a sine x, it can be cos x, or a sine x plus cos x, anything like that. That we will talk very soon. So anyway, y of x t dash represent displacement of the wave. Okay, please keep understand it thoroughly. It's very very important idea. Y of x t dash represent a displacement of the wave at a distance x, or you can say at the point P at the time instant P dash. At the time instant T dash. That is what, that is the wave at the origin at the time instant T. Okay, this T dash minus T shows the time taken to reach the wave. T dash minus T shows the time taken to reach the wave from origin to the point P. Understand? T dash minus T is the time interval. Okay, these are instances. T is instant, T dash is instant. So, for example, T is 9:30. And T dash is 9:45. So 15 seconds or 15 minutes took the wave to travel from origin to the point B. Okay, so T dash minus T shows the interval. And T and T dash are instants, time instants you can say. 12:30, 9:30 or 8:35 like that. That instant. And T dash minus T is the difference or time interval. Okay. So in general, so T, now you can write T dash minus T, you can write like this F of T dash minus X by V. Why? Because T is the time taken and T is equal to distance by velocity. Okay, you know, you have the fundamental idea of velocity and time. So we replace the T with the X by V. So this is what now, this is the displacement of the wave at the distance X at the time instant T dash. Understand? So very physically meaningful representation is that. So what does it mean? Once again we are saying disturbance at the point O, at the origin, will reach the point P, okay, reach the point P after a time X by V. Okay, that is the physical meaning of this equation. Disturbance at the origin will reach the point P, P is here, okay, P after a time X by V. Okay, that is the physical meaning. And disturbance at the point P at time T will be same as the displacement at the origin at the point O x by v seconds earlier. Okay, some x by v some t seconds. Okay, some t seconds back previously, historically back, the same disturbance happened at the origin. Okay, that reached at the point P after a time t minus t dash minus t. So that is the meaning of this equation. I hope the idea is clear to you. And function f represents the wave shape and size of the wave. Okay. What kind of a wave is? That is decided by f. It can have any form, as I told you. It may be simple sinusoidal function, it may be simple cosinusoidal function, or it can be combination of sinusoidal and cosinusoidal function. That depends on the complexity of the wave. But in this chapter, introductory chapter, we will simply assume that have a simple sinusoidal function. Understand? Sinusoidal function. Then we will proceed. Okay. So, let's see now. So, we talked so far about a forward going wave. A forward going wave. A wave going in the positive x direction. That we can represent generally like this. Generally, we can represent a forward wave because f y of x t. Y is a disturbance. Okay, that is equal to f of. F is the shape, it decides. It's the character, designs, it's a symbolic representation. F is a symbolic representation. It can be either a sine function or a cos function. F of t minus x by v. And similarly, if a wave is coming back, okay, propagating in the negative x direction, then you can represent it like this. Y of x t is equal to f of t plus x by v. Okay, you see the difference. A plus is coming for the a reverse wave or a negative propagating wave or a reflected wave, you can say. Suppose we have a wave which is okay, we have a medium and where both waves are existing. It's a forward wave and there is a backward wave, okay, a reverse wave. Then you can have a combination of all these two. So the total wave in the medium will be f of t minus x by v plus g of t plus x by v. Okay. So this is general case only, keep in mind. Normally we will talk about a forward going wave alone. So then the first expression is enough. Okay, first one is enough. The second one is not enough. Okay, the reflected wave is shown with a G. because it may be different wave, may be different wave shape, may be different. Its amplitude may be different from the incident wave. So generally, we is represented using a notation G. Suppose amplitude is same as the previous one, then you can simply represent as f of t plus x by v, f of t plus x by v. Suppose there is some change in the reflected wave, you can use G notation. Otherwise, okay. Okay, so we say that f and g are arbitrary functions. That means it can assume any functional form, either sine, cosine, like that. Okay, so that is the meaning. And in general, okay, now let's come to a specific example for a wave, how we can represent it mathematically, exactly how we can represent a wave. That is what is given here. A wave is mathematically represented like this. Our previous concept is used here. Instead of f's a real form is given here. F has a amplitude part and a sinusoidal part. Okay, and you can see now y of x t. What is y of x t? Displacement of the wave at a distance x at a time t. It's called a sine 2 pi by lambda x minus vt. This one already you have seen. Understand? This is the exact mathematical representation of a wave moving in the positive x direction. Suppose the wave is moving in the negative x direction, instead of minus, you will have a plus sign. Understand? Plus sign. Okay. That is first thing. And you know what is a lambda? Lambda is the wavelength of the wave. Wavelength of the wave. And v is the velocity. And the after all the terms coming after sine function. Okay. You can say from here to here. This is actually called the phase of the wave. Understand? Phase of the wave. Phase of the wave. Okay, see, it is like something like a sine theta. Okay, theta is embedded in this whole expression. A sine theta. Okay, and it is a time dependent function. Also a space dependent function. So its value vary with the x and t. Understand? So it's a completely it's time dependent, space dependent quantity. Keep in mind. I hope the idea is clear. This is a basic equation required for throughout this chapter, and this is a general equation for a wave. General, or you can say specific. General already we have seen. This is specific wave equation for a plane progressing wave. Okay, and let us see some of the symbols used here. We can make some changes. First thing, you have a 2 pi by lambda here. Normally people substitute 2 pi by lambda with a constant k. This is called wave number of the wave. Understand? Wave number. And you know 2 pi is in radian, lambda is in meter. So unit of wave number will be radian per meter. Okay, but it is known as wave number. Okay, number of waves containing 1 meter. You can say like that. And if you multiply 2 pi here, 2 pi v by lambda, okay, 2 pi v by lambda here, second term. Again, you can see v by lambda is here. Understand? V by lambda. V by lambda is called frequency of the wave. So, we have substituted with the frequency. And 2 pi into frequency is called angular frequency. We have already studied it. Okay, so that is denoted with omega. Omega. Okay. So, let us see now. We can make some replacement here. 2 pi by lambda, you can put with k. And 2 pi lambda v by 2 pi v by lambda is omega. So our wave form will be like this. You can see now k is here, 2 pi v by lambda is omega. So you got a new form, y of x t is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. Okay, so this is another wave equation, same as earlier one. We made some substitution. Both are equally correct. Understand? Both are equally correct, but expressed in two different methods. That is all. But you should be thorough with both equations. You should be thorough with both equations. Okay. Another important concept, as I already told you, about the phase of a wave. What is the phase of a wave? In this expression, you can see wave equation is shown here, and the phase of the wave is actually whatever parameter coming in within the bracket is called phase of the wave. Okay. Phase of the wave. And here sine kx minus omega t. Kx minus omega t is called actually the phase of the wave. or you can define it as argument part of the wave is called phase of wave. That is usually denoted with phi. Okay, you can show this with phi. Understand? So argument part of the wave is called phase of the wave, and it is phi, and it's shown here. Okay, so hope the idea is clear. What is the physical meaning of this phase of the wave? Will tell you where any particle of the medium remain at a particular time instant. Understand? Because there is a constant vibration of all the particles up and down at different points. So phase of the wave will give you displacement of the particle at a distance x at a time t. Understand? Or position, angle. Okay, phase of the wave will, or in other words, you can say phase of the wave will help you to understand the displacement of any particle of the medium at any time instant. Understand? So phase, without phase, you cannot understand the displacement of the particle at any time instant and at any x value. Once again, phase of the wave will help you to understand the displacement, the displacement of the particle of the medium at any distance at any time instant. Okay, so you can say that the phase will show the instantaneous position of the particle of the medium at any distance from the origin. You cannot say directly show, it will help you because you have to take the sign of that and you have to multiply with amplitude. Then you will get the actual position. Understand? So this will help you. Understand? Without this, you cannot find. You have to multiply with A. You have to take the sign of that. Hope this idea is clear. Very simple one, but it's very important. And phi is, as discussed, phi is equal to kx minus omega t. And suppose at the origin, sometime at the origin, wave may start from zero. Okay, and time is equal to zero. Wave may start from zero, but at some occasion wave may start at some other distance. Okay, some other height. Suppose time clock ticks zero, then wave start from zero, then phi will be zero. But it is not always necessary. Certain time wave may start from some initial amplitude, some initial displacement. Okay, say here or from here or from here. Then we have to add some phase here. Okay, some initial phase. Phi zero. For initial phi zero shows at from what point the particle starts to oscillate. You can say at what, from what point the particle start to oscillate. Whether it is from origin, if it is starting from origin, phi zero will be zero. If it is not from origin, phi zero will be non-zero. Understand? So that way you can characterize with a phi zero. It is not always necessary. It is necessary whenever particle motion is not beginning from origin, from some other point, just like in a race track people run. Okay, so different people are put at different points. So suppose there is a stadium inside that there is elliptical tracks, okay, where you know people are put at different point, not at same line. Okay, they have given some phase differences to so that their distance of running will be same. Okay, so similar idea. Okay, phase is given here, and of course, the phase is a function of position and time. That is also clear from the equation. X is there, time is there. So phase is a function of position and time. Phi of x t you can write. And let us once again understand the physical sense of this equation. We have already written A is equal to A sine 2 pi by lambda x minus v t. Okay. Suppose you put here time t is equal to 0. So what will happen to this equation? This equation becomes, this is 0. So what is left now? Y of x 0 is equal to A sine 2 pi by lambda into x. This is disappearing. And now you can, this is showing what is the wave when time is frozen. When time is frozen, time is not there. Then you can plot it. You give a different value for x. Lambda is constant, say 1 meter, 2 meter, something like that. And A amplitude also you can give some value. And if you start plotting it, plotting it, you will get a graph like this, a still graph, still not moving at all. Understand? It's not moving. Why? Because there is no time parameter here. You just put a different values of x along the horizontal direction. X is horizontal. Okay, why is this? So you can plot a graph like this. Anybody can do it. Anybody can do in a graph paper. Okay, so now we got the idea of without the time, what will happen to this function. And suppose now we put x is equal to 0 here. X is 0 means Now the body comes to the origin. Okay, for particle is origin. And x is 0, if you put here, what happened to the equation? You get x is 0, so y of 0 t is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda into vt. X is 0, so minus sign you can, for the time being, you can neglect. Okay, minus, you're simply putting a minus over here, nothing else. So, you can see now 2 pi v by lambda into t. Okay, and 2 pi by lambda, you already know, that is k. And v by lambda is frequency of the wave. So, if you put u0 is equal to a sine 2 pi ft. And 2 pi ft is what actually? It is the angular frequency omega. So, what happens when x is placed 0? You get a time varying function, simply time varying, no space dependency, nothing. A sine omega t. Again, if you plot it, what will happen? You get a graph like this. You see that particle is simply moving up and down. So, placing t is equal to 0, we got a curve like this, a static curve like this. Placing x is equal to 0, you got a time varying oscillation, simply up and down vibration. Suppose now you embed both in this equation. You put both x, both time. So, then what happens? You see now, you get a continuously propagating wave. Okay. So, in this equation, two physical ideas are compressed or two physical ideas are embraced. One is a sinusoidal wave function, a still wave function. One is an oscillating parameter. Two parameters when combined together in the equation, that means when x and t continuously changes. In the first case, we freeze the time. In the second case, we freeze the x. And now we give freedom for both time and x. Time is also varying, x is also varying. So what happened? You get a propagating wave. That is a real spirit of this mathematical equation. It's a very beautiful, fantastic mathematical equation, which clearly illustrates how a wave really propagates. Okay, I hope the beauty of this equation is clear to all of you. Okay, that is this explanation given just to understand the physical beauty of the wave function. Okay, so now again let us proceed. The next idea is phase velocity of a wave. What is a phase velocity means? Okay, you know that already you know phase. What is a phase? Okay. Phase is equal to phi is equal to kx minus omega t. And the phase, you can take the phase of any wave at any point. Okay, suppose you take a point here, you take a point here. Suppose one point. One point here and one point here. They are points of constant phase. Means they are at equal displacement from the mean position or from the x-axis. Any two points you can take. Any two points on two waves. One here. Or one here and one here. They are points of constant phase. Then, okay, that idea I hope you have. So, you can select any such a points of constant phase. So, here, for two points of constant phase, phi will be same. For two points of constant phase, phi will be same. Okay. So, if you differentiate this equation, phi is equal to kx minus omega t. So, we get a d phi by dt. Okay. So, d phi by dt is equal to, differentiate other side also, we have k into dx by dt minus omega t, omega dt by dt. Okay. Just to differentiate each term. Okay. So, differentiate each term. So, we get k into dx by dt minus omega into dt by dt. K and omega cannot differentiate because they are constants. Okay. And now see again. So dt by dt is equal to 1. Okay. Dt by dt is equal to 1. So then we can write d phi by dt is equal to k into dx by dt minus omega. Now problem. Again, you know, for points of constant phase, suppose I take two points at equal distance from the x, they are called the points of constant phase. So, for such points, phi will be constant. Understand? Phi will be constant. So, you can write d phi by dt is equal to 0. So, d phi by dt is equal to 0. So, what we get? We can write omega. Or anyway, omega. K into dx by dt minus omega is equal to 0. or omega minus k into dx by dt is equal to 0. Now I simply made a change here. What is here? X is the position of points of constant phase. Along the x-axis, we took all those points of constant phase. So simply for convenience only, okay, this is only for convenience, we wrote it as x for constant phase. Okay, so omega minus k into dx by dt is equal to 0 for points of constant phase, d phi by dt is equal to 0. Okay, and say just make modifications. So you can write here dx of constant phase by dt is equal to omega v. Rate of change of position of points of constant phase. That is the meaning of this equation. Time rate of change of points of constant phase. Okay, that is x phase. So that is equal to omega by k. So what we get? Dx by dt shows rate of change of displacement. That is called velocity. Okay, so we can write it as phase velocity. So phase velocity means what? Rate of change of displacement of points of constant phase. That means it, with what velocity points of constant phase move along the medium. Okay, in this case, for example, you can mark with the red dot some points. These are points of constant phase. So you can say that this is the velocity with which the red dot moves ahead. Red dot moves ahead. That can be found if you know the angular frequency of the wave and the wave number of the wave. Dividing angular frequency with the wave number, you can find the phase velocity of the wave, or with what velocity the wave is in fact moving through the medium. Okay, we call it as phase velocity. Hope the idea is clear, and this is illustrated beautifully here. In this case, you can take this as a pulse, continuous pulses are coming. So any points you can take from one plus, well, you take one point from here, second plus, corresponding point from the second pulse, and with what distance those points are moving. It is shown in both graphs, it is shown. Okay, you can mark a blue red dot here, then all the red dots are moving the same velocity. Otherwise, there will be a wavelength will be changing. Understand? So that is not there. Hope this idea is clear. And this again shown here, we can also define a phase velocity as the velocity with which the points of constant phase on a wave advances ahead. And it is called, it is also known as wave velocity. Okay, it is also known as wave velocity. For the given wave equation, we have omega, we have k. For any wave, you find out omega and k out of which, converting the given equation to this form and divide omega with k, you will get the phase velocity of the wave. Okay. And you can also understand it in another way. Consider a wave. Okay, this is black one is one wave, it is propagating. And the blue is also the same wave, its position is given after a time interval delta t. Okay, at a time t, black wave is there, and after a time delta t, the black wave reached some distance ahead. Okay, that is shown with a white shadow, okay, white line. Okay, and you take one point on the black wave and one point on the white wave. And they are points of constant phase. From the figure you can see, they are points of constant phase. That means their displacement from the x-axis is same. Okay. So for the first wave, for black wave, you can write the point A. Okay. This is shown with A. You can write as y of x t is equal to A sine 2 pi by lambda x minus v. Okay. This point. Okay. Why is the displacement of the point A, wave 1, you can say. And for at the point B, you can see we have the second wave. Second wave, okay. B, you can take it as second wave. And they are points of constant phase. That means height is same from the x-axis. For that point, you can write as y of x is now changed to x plus delta x. Because y was advanced. Wave advanced little ahead. Say delta x distance ahead. So x plus delta x. And this is the portion of the wave after a time instant t plus delta t. So we added a t with delta t. So other side also similarly you can have to add x will be added with x plus delta x, t will be added with t plus delta t. So you can imagine you have taken two photos of a propagating wave. One photo at the time instant t and another photo of the wave after a time t plus delta t. You took two photos, separate photo snaps. So quotients can be then mathematically marked like this: one y of x t and one y u of x plus delta x t plus delta t. So two ways. And for these two points, displacement is same. So you can equate both right hand side. Understand? We have taken points of constant phase on both waves because wave is advancing. So we took two points and we assume that both points are of constant phase or in same phase. Then you can equate the right hand side. Okay, since they are points of constant phase. Condition is that you have to take both points at the constant phase or constant height from the simplicity. You understand like that, constant height from the x-axis. So you can equate the right hand side. So what we get? Yes, a sine 2 pi by lambda x minus vt is equal to this one. Okay, that is shown here. Okay, so that means you can equate the argument. Other things are same. A cancelled. Sine of this and sine of this. So argument part you can equate. When you equate the argument part, 2 pi by lambda you can avoid because that is same. So x minus vt is equal to x plus delta x minus v into t plus delta t. We get. Okay. So again we can expand it. X minus vt is equal to x plus delta x minus v into t plus delta t. Okay. We expanded it, multiplied it. So x plus delta, right hand side is expanded. Vt. So vt you can cancel. Understand? X you can cancel. So what is left now? Minus vt. Okay. Minus v delta t plus delta x is equal to 0. That is left. Okay. That is left. Or again rearrange, you get v is equal to delta x by delta t. Okay. That means if you know the displacement of the points of constant phase and within what time it happens, that will show you the velocity of the phase or velocity of the wave. Okay. So this is an illustration of showing wave phase velocity can be found by delta x by delta t. Understand? Or it's a physical illustration of the concept of phase velocity. Okay. Previously we said that wave velocity, phase velocity equal to omega by k. But in this case, we investigated or elaborated or demonstrated it in a physical way. Understand? Demonstrated the concept of phase velocity in a physical way using some mathematics. Hope this idea is clear. And this velocity is actually called phase velocity. Okay, that is what is given here. Okay. So I hope these ideas are clear. We have tried to illustrate them beautifully. Hope you understood it. And here is a simple assignment for you. Okay. A traveling wave, a wave is traveling along a string given by the function y is equal to 15 cos 0.25x plus 75 t. Okay. You can compare it with our previous standard equations. Okay, we have made a standard wave equation for x and y are millimeters and t is in seconds. Find the amplitude, wavelength, frequency, velocity of the wave. In what direction is the wave traveling? You can easily find. You can write the standard wave equation. You have this equation. You can either write in cos form or sine form. At the beginning itself, I have told you. Okay. So it is in cosine form. So standard equation is given here. Here in our case, the present problem plus is there. Okay. In the argument 0.25x plus 75 t. So plus means something a wave is propagating in the negative x direction. So you can write the corresponding wave equation plus. Oh yes. Now you write this equation here. You can compare all the parameters, all the wave parameters, omega, k, x, a, everything you can compare. You will get the parameter being asked. And velocity is also asked. And you already studied what is the equation for finding velocity of wave. And in what direction wave is traveling. That is also obviously clear from the equation. Okay. Always whenever such problems you get, you write the standard equation of a wave either in cosine form or in sinusoidal form. Then combine it. That is the simplest method. Okay. So hope you understood it. You do it neatly and correctly. Here is second assignment. It is a very simple question. Calculate the frequencies of radio wave of wavelength 1500 meter. And you know a relation between wavelength, frequency and speed. Okay. One is, first one is radio wave. It is electromagnetic wave. So velocity is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So that idea is there. so you can surely find it. It's a simple question, but just to familiarize the different types of wave. Okay. Another one is given a photon of wavelength 500 nanometer. Okay, you have to find the frequency. So in every case, you can use the velocity of the wave as 3 times 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters. Okay, and second is the X-ray is given, and another one wave number is given. We have already talked about wave number K. So I hope the idea is clear. You can surely do it nicely. All are requested to watch this video at least 2 or 3 times. Okay, neatly watch the whole video and take a lecture note. Otherwise, you cannot understand the things. There is no complexity or no difficulty in understanding the wave theory. But provided that you carefully watch the whole video once or twice and take down a neat lecture note. Then after that, you do the assignment. Okay. If you can do all this, you will be surely thorough with the idea of wave theory, fundamentals of wave theory. So with this comments, let us sign off. Thank you all of you.